Good morning, it's Monday, and it's Monday, June 19th. I'm in Las Vegas, and I'm continuing to answer questions that are coming through discoveringyourcosmicself.com. The questions are based on readers who are having queries after reading You Are the Universe, Discovering Your Cosmic Self and Why It Matters. I thank you for expanding this conversation, and I thank very much all of you for continuing to stay here on these sites, and we can this way continue expanding our awareness together. So today's question is from Susie. She says, why do we go through duality here on this plane of existence when in our own true state there is no duality? Are we living a spiritual existence to discover that there is no duality, or are we living a human existence with spiritual experiences and duality to remind us of who, what we are? If the world and us in the world of existence is a world that is perfect, why do we create such duality upon this level of existence on earth? In my own meditations, I feel calm at one. Sometimes I break through to no thought, just at a place where there is only being. Why do we come here to such an experience when we all are actually whole and from such a consciousness? There is no time, no struggle, just pure wholeness. So that's a good question, Susie, but that question itself comes from the place of duality. Okay, because when you're in the place of non-duality, there are no questions, no need for answers, just being, just bliss, just awareness, just truth. Sat, Chit, Ananda. Sat means truth, Chit is awareness, Ananda, bliss. It's actually the peace that passes understanding, the peace beyond all understanding. Eternal bliss consciousness. So then, why go through this plane of existence that we call duality? Well, because existence needs experience. And in the non-dual state, even though we call that an experience, it is actually just existence prior to all experience. It is existence without any experience. It is an experience of just being. And although it is blissful and peaceful, there is no contrast. In order to experience existence, we need subject-object split, we need contrast, me and the other, pleasure and pain, joy and suffering, birth and death, hot and cold, up and down, disease and perfect ease, thought and action, me and the other, allies and enemies. Even the so-called enemies are implicit allies. They sustain each other, you know, in order to keep the show going on. So the simplest answer to your question is, why do we go to the movies? You know, because the movies have heroes, but they also have villains. the movies have sinners, they also have saints. The movies have those that are victors and those that have been vanquished. The movies have faith and love, but they also have betrayal and intrigue. That's what makes a good movie. So the universal being, being formless, is also infinite, but self interacts to experience itself in maximum diversity. Maximum diversity. And part of that diversity entails suffering, because in the absence of suffering, it might be difficult to experience joy in the relative plane of existence. In the absolute plane of existence, there is no contrast. So there is only unvarnished, untouched bliss awareness. But that bliss awareness can, from a relative point of view, from the relativistic point of view, lead to boredom. So the play of consciousness as the material world, the play of consciousness as the experience of the material world, although the feeling of the individual I and the feeling of the individual other is both basically a modification of consciousness itself, a modification of consciousness in, as me and other, a qualia experience as me and other, a quality modified form of consciousness called perceptual experience, and then its interpretation called mental experience. But in reality, all is self-interaction, all knowers, all modes of knowing, all objects known, all seers, all modes of seeing, and all possible sceneries. So Susie says, in my meditation I feel calm. There is no time, no struggle, just pure wholeness. If you can bring that wholeness that you have into the world of everyday reality, then you are a true yogi. Lord Krishna calls it Yogasth Guru Karmani. Established in yoga, perform action. Which means there's a part of you that is never overshadowed by the time-bound scenery. The scenery is time-bound. The seer is timeless. And if you can be fully engaged and detached at the same time, fully engaged and centered as the seer, then you will begin to overcome suffering in the relative world. You will begin. There will always be some, because as I said, experience is by contrast. So this is what it means. Carry your peace, carry your center of being in the midst of chaos, unpredictability, confusion, and all the melodramatic insanity of the world that we are witnessing right now. Yogasth Guru Karmani. Established in yoga, established in being, established in the source of existence. As existence, perform action and play in the relative world. This is freedom in your present incarnation, what is called Jivan Mukti. Jivan Mukti. Freedom from karma, even as you engage in action. Freedom from the fragmented mind, settling in the whole mind, even as you perform action in the relative world. This is the beauty of this understanding that we call yoga. to know at all times that you're a non-local formless being having an experience in the world of space-time and causality in this playhouse of forms. As Tagore said in one of his most beautiful poems, in this playhouse of infinite forms, I caught sight of that which is formless, and so my life is blessed. Blessed. Because when you're settled in being, you also know your purpose in the relative. You also know how to actualize your dreams in the relative. You also know how to take wholeness into the world. You also know how to heal and be healed. To be holy, to be healed, to be whole are the same place. But this is not a location in space-time. It is timeless being in eternity. So I hope this is answering your question, Susie. Thank you for asking it. And thank you everyone for being here. And I'll see you tomorrow. I'll still be in Las Vegas, but I'll touch base with you tomorrow before I leave for New York. Thank you. Have a good day. God bless. Keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for the stars, because you are in fact a stardust being with self-awareness.